Yo, what's good, IG? It's your boy Jav. Here with a special vid for y'all, man. It's like 5:30 in the morning. I ain't really been asleep. I just been up, just was totally inspired for the last couple hours. You know, just got some downloads, and I wanted to hurry up and hop on here and share the information with y'all. Hopefully, get y'all some game. Hopefully, y'all get some value from it. If you're watching on YouTube, shout out to y'all too. You know, trying to make this video quick because IG only allows like 10-minute videos. So yeah, man, let's hop straight into it. So it's going to be, as you can tell by the title, The 7 Steps to Business Innovation. So, you know, the last couple hours I've just been digging into the etymologies of like these different words that you see right here and just the histories of them and just kind of really trying to dig into what they really mean and how it can be applied to a process. And I kind of just got this, you know, like I said, download, right? So, you know, say you have an idea or you have the desire to want to start a business, or you want to start, you know, doing something, right? You have a desire to do something, right? So usually that's going to stem first from an idea. And I got some notes right here if y'all keep wondering why I keep looking down. But yeah, so really from your idea stage, so idea, like I said, I've been digging into the etymologies a little bit. And idea is basically something from nothing. So I like to put everything in a biblical way, biblical principles, because I feel like that's the greatest wisdom ever. So if you think of ideas, God. So let's say in the beginning, God created. So before you get to create, you had God. So that's the idea. That's the ideal. You know, you have to have an ideal of what you want to do. And I feel like that ideal, especially in business, should come from a relationship of identifying a problem. So get concrete on a problem that you want to solve and how you're going to solve it. The solution, problem and solution, nice and simple. And, you know, innovation in itself, what that means is to, you know, renew or restore. So basically how I took that, renew or restore, is to return to ideal human conditions. You know, it's return back to perfect, you know, because God, you know, in the beginning, he was perfect. Eden was perfect, you know, so we're kind of all just trying to get back to that, right? So that's why I say innovation. So idea, problem, solution. Only reason we have problems is because we're human, and the human part of us is the only part that has problems, and the God part of us is the part that gives us the idea that actually had a solution to help us out. So it's actually kind of crazy, right? So like I said, ideas usually gonna come right out of nowhere. And keep in mind, with your idea, this is your setting foundation to everything else should be filtered through that. So I'm gonna get more into that later, but in your idea stage, this is where you come up with your principles, your values, your mission, your purpose, and the vision, right? Those five things, that's what you want to come with me, your idea. I'm gonna go more in depth in more videos. This, like I said, gotta be quick. I got the timer right here too, and we already running out of time, so let's move on. So next we're gonna go to create. So create is just setting the intention to act upon your idea. So you want to set the intention to act upon your idea. So this is like the mindset stuff. This is where you you know, you have to believe before you can do something. So setting the intention, let's put that right there. Intention, this is gonna be all over the place. This was idea, this was create. So intention, and intention, you'll get that from belief, right? Believing you can do something. You get belief from confidence, and confidence should come from awareness. So it really boils down to awareness, and by awareness I mean knowing who you are, knowing that you are an image of God, knowing that you have the ability inside of you to do anything. Anything's possible, right? It says that all things are possible to him who believes, right? So set the intention, know you could do it, work on your mindset, work on your self-image, work on all that type of stuff. Mindset, like I said, we gotta move on. Next, design. So this is where you start the process. This is foundation. Start the process. Do the blueprints. You know, this is blueprints. This is foundation building. This is your rough draft, you know. It says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and it was formless and without void. You know, formless and void, right? So there was nothing. He just set the foundation. He just laid the keys, you know. There wasn't nothing. It wasn't no animals. It wasn't no plants. It wasn't no people. It wasn't no sun. It wasn't no moon. It was just formless without voice. So he designed it first, set the foundation. Next, he produced. So you produce, and by produce, I mean refine your solution until it's a productized version of the idea. Refine your solution until it's a productized version of the idea. So this is where you build the house. You got your blueprints, now you actually have to build it. And through this process, what you should be doing is testing, you know, testing different things and, you know, trial error, figuring it out, you know, going back and forth, you know, trying to make it work. And you should be getting feedback from the filtration of your ideation alignment. So you should be trying to align your production with your idea and filter your production through that idea, through your mission, through your values, through your principles. So like, for example, if I'm trying to create a course, a fitness course, right? I have to, and one of my values, one of my ideas that fitness and, you know, all this type of stuff is gonna come through hard work. And when I'm building a course, I say something like, oh, you could get it, you know, get 6-pack abs in 30 days just by taking this little pill. That doesn't align. That's not a part of my idea. So that's not gonna be accurate and in alignment with your truth production, right? So you wanna, when you're producing, you wanna make sure it aligns with your ideas. Next, so let's go with alignment. I like that word right there. How much time we got? Woo, about down to 3 minutes. So after it's produced, now that you have your product, now that you have your productized solution, and it is in alignment with your original idea, your original plan. When you set out, this is how you thought it would look. Now that goes straight into the branding point. How should it look? You should have an idea of how that should look. You had an idea in your mind, and now you got your product in front of you. Now brand, the etymology of that is literally like stamping a brand of a cow, right? So picture like, you know, the hot thing, stamping it with a cow. So you're basically giving it your stamp of approval. And now it's ready to market. It's basically like saying, okay, cool, we ready to hit the market. So ready to hit the market, move on to market. And, you know, people get paid their whole life. This is what people do their whole life. So there's so much more to all these steps. This is just a quick overview. So keep that in mind. Now, marketing. This is where you're going to identify a group of people who will benefit most from the solution and presenting that solution to them. So ways you could present the solution to them is, stamped, that's for branding, and then present, that's marketing. So stamp of approval, this is terrible handwriting, but, and then presenting that to your market. So sometimes to present to your market, you have to keep in mind, okay, like I said, all this should be, it's part steps, it all goes hand in hand, everything is one. But, you know, part of that is identifying a specific group of people. So this is like your niche. Who do you want to serve? Where do they hang out? Are they on Facebook? Are they on Instagram? Are they, what type of lifestyle do they have? What's the age range? All this type of stuff. That's so important for marketing because you want to talk directly to that person because that's just going to help improve your sales, right? That's what we're trying to do. Serve value, you know, get the most value out there, and that's determined by money. That different story. So yeah, present your solution and convey it in a way, and you have to be aware of where your ideal client is in their journey of awareness of your of their problem, in a sense, right? Like some people don't even know they have a problem, so you might need to educate first. You know, you might need to put out value content like this, like, hey, you know, this is why you're serving that. And then you hit them with the solution. Kind of like jab, 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 right hook, what Gary Vee says. You know, you want to hit them with that value up front. And then now you can move into the sale. So this is just conveying your solution. So benefit, let's just go with that. Or money. Money and benefit, I guess. You're conveying the solution to your ideal market. So you're explaining the benefit and how it would fix their problem. You're explaining the solution and how it would benefit them, which is fixing their problem, my bad. So it's the act of selling, you know, it's just taking the payment, you know, handing off the solution. It's the service or product delivery. So whatever you're selling, whatever your it could be music, it could be a product, it could be a service. This is, you know, the sales call if you're selling a service, you know, hopping on a call with somebody. This could be somebody, God dang it. Yeah, man. Video probably gonna cut off, but yeah, that's basically it. I hope y'all enjoyed. If you did, let me know in the comments what you took away most. I'm probably gonna make more videos hopping into each one of these a little bit more in depth. This was just a quick overview, like I said.